Hi everyone, it's Emily Punt, Director of Athletics Annual Giving. Welcome again to another Augie Insider. I'm excited to recap this past week in the NSIC tournament today with Athletic Director Josh Morton, Coach Krauth, and Coach Bilder. So I will pass it off to Josh to get started.
March Madness started early for the NSIC. Quickly, we'll get to basketball here in a second, but over the weekend, had two wrestlers qualify for nationals up in the Super Regional in Aberdeen, Stephen Hodges and Brandon Carroll, potentially looking at potential third here today as well. Track and field, man, they had a wonderful weekend at the conference championships. Number of NSIC winners and provisional qualifiers and already national qualifiers. They'll learn more tomorrow. And then softball, first open the season down in Texas. I felt bad because I pulled into work this morning around 8 o'clock and their bus was just pulling in from Texas. So they finished up yesterday afternoon and hopped on the bus and headed north. So a busy weekend. Baseball gets started this week. Women's tennis had another sweep yesterday as well. But let's talk some basketball. We're going to start with women's basketball. Coach Krauth made it to the semifinals. A heartbreaker to lose it to St. Cloud. To talk about, I guess, the last maybe 10 minutes of that game where you had a comfortable lead. They come back, but you really did everything that you wanted to do to extend the game there in the last minute.
Well, yeah, I mean, it's always amazing. You play 40 minutes and then of course you, in close games, you remember the latter, you know, parts of the game. But it was one of those where, you know, we had a nice stretch to give ourselves a lead, and you use the word comfortable. I certainly wasn't, but, and then, just, you know, for, you know, who knows why, but it just, in fact, I was hollering at us, on the defensive end. I said, don't relax. It just looks like we're taking a play off here. And then they get, well, what almost looked like an easy basket here or there. And, you know, then we don't finish a couple and you know, the next thing, you know, our lead is gone. And then we, you know, tried to, you know, extend and play out the end as best we could and probably, you know, didn't get a whistle when we absolutely had to have one, on kind of our last possession. Yep. But you know, that game, you know, turned out, if you look at the stat sheet, I mean, I don't know. I mean, it was both that game, but the weekend. I told KB this morning, I asked her, I've said, you know what, our starting perimeter shot from the 3-point range in the two games, and she was close, but I mean, they were like 1 for 17. Now, if you go with your starting perimeters, 1 for 17, I mean, that stat in itself would probably tell you you're putting yourself in a tough spot. So yeah. It wasn't, you know, we didn't shoot in well enough probably to win games. And going back to the Moorhead, we just had a great fourth quarter that, you know, erased everything else in that game.
Yeah. Well, we'll get back to you in a second because postseason, we'll learn more this week about the next step. Coach Bilder, a heartbreaker in the quarterfinals, take Northern State to overtime. It's always tough to see the season come to an end, especially when you're playing your best basketball.
Yeah, it's 2 years in a row. I think we were as good as anybody in the tournament. We keep shooting ourselves in the foot during the regular season, and we end up having to play the other team, who's arguably the best team at the end of the year, you know, either in the second or first round. And you know, credit Northern. They did a great job. It was a great game. You know, they've got such a unique team. I really think the world of Saul Phillips. I've known him forever. And I think the world of their players, they play hard. They have a lot of enthusiasm. Our team enjoys playing them. I think it's the same vice versa. And, you know, I didn't hear his interview afterwards, but Saul had a great line when I heard it replayed on watching the games the next night. I know Brad Newitt was saying how he said it feels kind of marchy out there. And he had texted me after the game and complimenting us and how well we played vice versa. And both of us agreed the saddest thing about that game. Well, I have a little bit of a sadder thing. We lost, but you know, what a great game if there had been 3,500, you know, with that Northern's fans and our fans and the atmosphere and what that would have meant for our student athletes to be a part of that. Yeah. We've been pretty special. So, you know, a great college basketball game. Could have gone either way. It went their way. It has for the last three times we've played them. All of our games last year in January and then last year's game and this year. You know, we could talk about it forever, the ifs and whats and maybes and buts, but in the end, you know, we tied it in regulation. We needed to find one more point then, and they really responded well in the overtime, played very, very well. We hung in there. We fought it to the end, you know, missed the free throw on purpose, run the ball down, needed Ty to work on that old Kareem Jabbar sky hook from that corner. We didn't get much of a shot out of it. That's right. Maybe that would have given us a chance to tie it back up, but execution at the end was well done by Matt Todd and what have you. We just didn't get it done. So, you know, tough one. It was hard to watch the rest of the games this weekend because you would love to have been that team playing in it and getting to the finals. And our fans would have loved that as one of my players. And, you know, we're right there. You know, we're not very, very far from being there. That's for sure. And kind of like Dave said, you know, you hate a whole game goes on. You kind of remember one or two plays at the end more than what happened for the 40, in our case, 45 minutes before. So, you know, kids gave a valiant effort. Their kids played hard, and it was a great college basketball game.
Yeah, how would you sum up your season, Coach Builder? I mean, it's such a unique you go through 16 games of only conference, the anxiety, honestly, of going through testing. Are we negative? Are we positive? Is the other team? How would you describe the year in general?
I think it's one of the greatest things I've ever been through. I've never been more proud of our administration, our team, our players, our parents, my staff. You know, I didn't even have my staff this week. And all week, Matt Cartwright did such a great job. Matt was an assistant coach. Coach Cartwright, I kidded our guys, had to call him Coach Cartwright, and Chad Hederman to come back. And the job Chad did, you know, Colin and Casey and Michaela all week, up all hours of the night, sending us in, you know, computer emails, doing the game prep. They put it together on the computer, the official scout, to give to our players. So, you know, it was an unbelievable team effort. And I don't know if people understand, they might think it was odd that I bring Chad Hederman back, you know, and he actually gave the pregame scout and what have you, what I was doing. It was hard for me, but I wanted everything to be, I worked as hard as I could work to make it as normal a week as I could for our players. I did not want them to think, you know, oh, we don't have our staff. We don't have the, everything's going to get, I just wanted it as normal as it could be. And, you know, Chad's been with me for 15, 16 years. Our guys were very comfortable with it. Entire staff did an outstanding job. And just the way our players handled it, so proud of them. You know, to go through a year like this and to see everyone's commitment and effort and ability to bend. I mean, we flat out had a team tell us during the year, they just don't want to play. I mean, you know, that's crazy, you know, and my guys were just great with it. So, you know, was it easy? No, you know, I'm a worrier. The more worrying about if we're going to have a negative or a positive test, I'm sorry, or the opponent, that was hard. I'd be lying if I didn't say that, but overall, it'll be something I'll never forget. And I just feel, honored and blessed that we were able to play and to get through it. And it's something that I'll always remember.
Yeah, no, thank you. Coach Kraft, big week to find out NCAA tournament. I'll just give people a quick rundown of how it's going to work this year. The Central Region is now only the MIAA and the NSIC. The GAC has gone to a different region just for this year, just because of sheer numbers across the country. So only going to take six teams. The Wednesday will be the first rankings where they actually rank the teams. The past couple of weeks, it's been who's in the mix. Augustana has been in the mix from the start. And so Wednesday will be a ranking. MIAA has their tournament this weekend. Sunday night's the selection show at 9 o'clock Central Time. So Coach, 10-2, your last 12 games, swept Sioux Falls, playing great basketball at the end. How will you handle this week with your team, not knowing for sure if you're in to the tournament?
Well, you know, that's a tough thing. That's the toughest thing about us playing an early tournament. Also, if you're a bubble team, you just got time on your hands. And so we'll try to get a good workout in tomorrow, Tuesday. And then if the rankings come out, time-wise during the day on Wednesday, and it looks like we're not going to be in, then we may play it pretty loose and almost, you know, take it as if our season would be over. If we're, you don't know what it's going to say or what it's going to do. And like you said, the MIAA has their tournament yet to play, but they're going to end up with four teams with very good records. And that's kind of the bottom line this year, where they're looking at your records. And a lot of the other things that have been factored in they aren't absolutely being used. And so I think it's kind of an individual thing, depending on the regional ranking committee, what they decide to take into consideration and everything. And then, of course, my assumption is that St. Cloud will move into somewhere in those rankings. And with us, that, you know, that's our head-to-head game, and we lost. So, equal, you know, our records are the same, and head-to-head doesn't bode well for us. So, you know, we probably somehow some things have to fall our way now that out of our control.
Yeah. I would just point out, I think for us, our five losses were to quality opponents. Didn't have what a committee would call a quote unquote bad loss. Swept Sioux Falls when they were in the rankings. So I feel like we have an awfully good resume. So I look forward to going down to Warrensburg, Missouri, Central Missouri, hosting the Central Region this year. So, but yeah, we'll wait and see Wednesday, and then for sure on Sunday as the rankings come out. I'm going to ask you both too, just to touch on next year a little bit, Coach Builder, especially for the men. You're excited about your recruiting class as well. I know Zach is still playing in Wisconsin.
Yeah, Zach Johnson, great game. I was telling you earlier this morning, watched it on Saturday night. They played De Pere, which is a powerhouse throughout the history of Wisconsin State basketball. And Zach had actually missed a free throw, which is uncharacteristic, and two pretty good looks earlier in the game. It was one of the best high school games you'll ever see, and it just was 1 point each way the whole way. And then when it really counted, he just rose up and drilled a three, put them up by one. They ended up going down, getting them to miss, rebound, game over. So Zach's in the final four teams at the state term. Wisconsin next weekend is going to play in the morning, and then they come back and play that night for the championship. So I'm sure with COVID, all the reasons. So they'll be pretty tired. He's got a very good team. They've done a great job this year. So, and then Angelo, you know, broke every record in Iowa, rebounding, scoring, all kinds of records. They got beat, I think, in the game before the regional championship, or the game before state, which is amazing because he lost a lot. Majority of his team graduated the year before, especially their backcourt. And Angelo just had a great year. And, you know, I feel like we get Akoya next year, who's had one of the best redshirt years. He's put on 15 pounds of muscle. He's a really good player. He's just done some phenomenal things this year for us in practice. And, you know, like I've been not even kidding, Matt Cartwright's out of legs. He's had them both fixed. He doesn't have a third. So, you know, hopefully he comes back next year. And whether we have to limit minutes, whatever, that can all be determined, worked with in terms of practices. Knowing Matt, he'll come back just roaring like a tiger. He sure wants to play. No one is going to work harder. And he means a lot to our team, and he's the captain of the team, even when he's not playing. I just wish people could have seen the week he put in last week as an assistant coach, the amount of film. I told him to watch the Mary games. I gave him like two or three films, and he watched them all twice, and his notes and his comments and his maturity. And he, you know, I hate to do this because I think his dad and mom will be mad at me. That kid needs going to coaching. I don't care how smart he is. And he's going to have all these master's degrees in business and everything. He a heck of a coach. And he'd be great at it. So, you know, just, we got a really good group coming back. And I think, you know, the majority of my team is in fact, they pretty much all have indicated they all want back, but that's good. But you know what? We got to get better too. You know, my comment after our game wasn't bad. I just said, guys, we got to get better. We're good. We got to get better. I got to get better. I got to do some things better coaching wise. And we got to get in that weight. We got to get a little bit better. You know, we're not there yet. We got to get better. And I think they all agreed with me, you know, saw a lot of head shaking. Yes. And a lot of sad eyes, but you know, that's what the spring and summer are for. And we need to have a great year of improvement, both on and off the floor in terms of the weight room and individual improvement.
Well, that's great. Coach Croft, you lose two seniors, Hannah and Izzy, both have jobs lined up. So they weren't going to going to come back. You knew that. I want you to talk about your two freshmen this year who were on your roster and who maybe people didn't get to see play a lot, but I know they were valuable for and it was a valuable year for them. And you look forward to seeing them along with your signees next year, but your two current freshmen too.
Yeah. Both Abby Phipps from Harrisburg, Joanna Miller from Brookings, you know, I thought had productive what normally would be redshirt years for them and made progress. You know, we're kind of like Tom said, did a good job making our practices as competitive as they could. I think they both have futures, and then how quickly, you know, that'll come to fruition. It's hard to predict, but there were days when Go-Go, Joanna Miller's nickname is Go-Go, but she's just a very physical, dominant kid inside, and I mean, you would see that some days in practice. And we weren't short of at least bodies, post types, but like I said, I mean, there were days where she was kind of the dominant inside force in our practice. So, you know, those two kids have both you know, progressed nicely, and they've got great attitudes. They work, and they'll continue to do that and try to have themselves ready come next year.
Oh, very good. All right, coaches, thanks very much for these Mondays. I think it's been really nice to recap and preview and then to engage with our fans however we could. Coach Krauth, I'm going to bank on having one more with you at least in 2 weeks. So
hope you guys have one. You deserve it. I hope that happens. Right. Josh, thanks to you and Emily for doing this. Appreciate it. It was a good thing to do. And I know our fans that I've visited with, a lot of them, you know, watch it when it's replayed on YouTube and different things too. And they all enjoyed it. So thanks for you guys doing this as well.
You bet. Thanks.
You got it. All right. Emily, I'm going to turn it over to you to wrap it up.
Great. Thank you, everybody. Thanks to those of you who have been along for the ride all season. Like we said, hopefully we have another one here in the next couple of weeks. We will keep you posted via email and on social media. So stay tuned, and we will hopefully see you soon. Have a great week.